welcome to Acme Machining. We've got the new milling machine in now, and we got to do a few more things to get it set up. We need to build some feet for it, so come along, we're going to have some fun, we're going to make some feet for the milling machine.
Room to put a 4-inch bolt in there. We're just going to make them out of threaded rod, and we're also going to make some little pedestal feet for underneath there too. Okay, so we've got this set at 4 inches, and we're going to go ahead and we're going to cut 4 of these off. We've got some 3-inch 1018 round stock, and I'm going to cut 4 of these off, just a little over an inch. We'll dress them up with the lathe afterwards. We'll give you a better shot of what we're doing here. Just touch off. Turn that in until it's just approximately 0. Chamfer on the other side. I'll finish the rest of them up off camera. Okay, I think you can see that. The end of the file, or the end of the thread, is a little bit screwed up there. So what I use is a thread file. And these here come with all the different thread pitches, most of the different thread pitches, I won't say all. because you guys will find one that it don't fit. And you just take and you run this here over your threads until you clean them up. It doesn't take off any good metal, it just takes off the bad stuff. So I'll finish these up off camera and I'll show you them when I'm done. And after cleaning these up with the thread file, they just spin together nicely. Now I'm just going to take these and put them in my 5C collet block because I want to put a couple wrench flats on the other end. So I'm just going to put them in like so. Grab it with soft jaws and tighten it up. And we'll go over to the new mill, make our first chips. We're not getting too fancy here. We're just using carpenter square to square off the block. We've just got a simple hold down and we're gonna come down, we're gonna touch the top of that and we're just gonna take enough off to probably turn it down to a half inch wrench. So I'm gonna go to the tripod now and take a skim on that. Just going to bring this down, excuse the arm for a minute, lock that down, and I'm just going to take enough off that I can use a wrench there. Clean this off and clamp the vise down. We cleaned it off, didn't get fancy or anything like that, just gave it a quick wipe down, a little bit of acetone. And I'm just gonna take a 125 off of each side. Just repeat that three more times and then we'll come back to you. Last one. This thing is so quiet and smooth. My other mill, I couldn't be doing videos because it's so noisy. It had a straight cut gearbox in it, and all you heard was the gears running in it. So I guess you get what you pay for. Buy once, try once. So there's the last one. I got two flats on each of them. And we'll get them cleaned up a little bit off camera, and we'll start for the little pedestal feet. So there we go. First chips on the new machine. Very happy with it. Got the threaded rods cut out for the feet. I'm just going to skim some off the nuts to get them down to thinner. I don't need a full 3/4 inch nut to sit in the way, and we'll get the little feet made also. Okay, folks, we literally have our nuts in the vise, and we're going to skim them down some to make them a little bit thinner. Up on this until I see a little bit of contact going on. Zero order Z. Come up 125. And we'll try our power feed. I'm going to move in the opposite direction to start because I want to see how quickly this is moving. Using 3-flute carbide end mills from Niagara Cutters. They make a great cutter. Wish I knew somebody to give me them because they're expensive, but they're a great cutter. Head trimmed in, I don't have my vise trimmed in, I don't have the machine level. I'm just trying to get some feet under it quickly because I'm working on 2x4 blocks, and that's not my preferred way of doing things. Once we get this thing set and level and firm, we will do everything we need to make sure that we're 100% level and trimmed in. Then we'll get our accuracy where we need it. Thank you.
four nuts in, so I can do this all in one sweep, but the nuts aren't all 100% perfect, so I had one in the middle that wanted to rattle, so I said, no, I don't need my nuts flying around. Get over how quiet this machine is. Pretty bad when you can go from a single phase machine to a phase converter and it's so much quieter. But then again, it's an American rotary, or Canadian rotary as we call it up here. Okay, I'm going to take another 125 off of these. It's nice to have a DRO, I tell you. Bring it back when I've got the four of these done. Just a simple boring operation here. Shooting from the hip, making them big enough that our pin goes in, has some room to move around. So I'm going to finish up the other three off camera here, and we'll get back to you.
got the four of these all made up, and wasn't nothing fancy. All I gotta do is make sure that that stays in there, and I'm sure 2200 pounds will make sure. So I'm just gonna sneak one in here. Bit of copper coat on it. We don't need the old rust bandits up here. And I was going to turn them down, clean up both sides after I cut them with the saw, but I measured them up, and the four of them were within 15 thousandths of an inch. So I said, there's something I don't need to do. That saw does a great job, so I figured let it do its job. And let me get this sitting on some steel. I'm going to set that under there just in case a 2x4 decides it doesn't like my fingers. There it is. One down, three to go. We'll bring you back later. Hey folks, don't laugh, but a carpenter's level says it's level. The sterret comes out tomorrow. Got to do a few automotive jobs too tomorrow, but she's sitting there. She wasn't sitting there this morning. She was out in the cold on the back of a truck, a modern tool, and an hour away. So we got her in here, we got her set up, and she's sitting on her own four legs. There's tension on all four legs. We will get the sterret machinist level out tomorrow or the next day. Tomorrow's Remembrance Day, so gotta go to the cenotaph and do the right thing. Support your vets, folks. We wouldn't be here without them. Have a good evening, and there's more to come.